told by a section of writers against what they label as rising intolerance shows no signs of abating. Leading Punjabi writer Daleep Kaur Tiwana has now decided to return her Padma Shri. Several other writers, including Assamese author Homen Bogohain and Kannada author Rahmat Tarikeri, have returned their Sahitya Academy Awards. With this, the number of rebellious writers is inching towards 30. But there is, of course, those who believe that these writers should not be returning their awards, including Chetan Bhagat, who has called it a political stunt. So where do we stand, or where do the writers stand? That's our next topic. So is returning the Sahitya Academy Awards the right step for writers to take? Let's carry forward this debate once more tonight. We're joined by two very special guests, both winners of Sahitya Academy. Mridula Garg, who's refused to return her award in a way, or chosen not to return her award, and Gurbachan Bhullar, who has chosen to return his award. Thank you both very much for joining us. Mridula Garg, you've written today in the Times of India where you have said that you do not see any reason to return the award, and you feel that those who are returning it are equating the academy as an autonomous body with the government. Why do you believe that writers who are returning the award are not taking the right step?
No, I have never said they are not taking the right step. What I said was, it is up to them. Each person will decide for himself.
It's a conscience call for each individual.
It's a conscience call, and each one is independent of any political party or ideology. He's deciding it for himself. My fear is that if a lot of writers return their awards, it may give the government an opportunity to declare that there is something wrong with the Sahitya Academy, and they'll put somebody of their own on the Sahitya Academy, taking away its autonomy.
You really think that the Sahitya Academy today is completely autonomous? You don't think it's a government, that the government puts pressure on the Sahitya Academy?
The government puts pressure on everybody, from the Grosa and the Panwari to the Gyanpeeth awardee. Everybody. It puts pressure on everybody. Some people refuse to be pressurized. Mm-hmm. Some people are killed because they refuse to be pressurized. Some people are arrested. And it is irrespective of which party is in power.
Okay, so I'll come to you in a moment, and I want to press the point as to why you believe writers should not return their awards, or you have chosen not to return your award. But Gurbachan Bhullar, aapne jab Sahitya Award return kiya, you said ki social fabric jo hai desh ki, wo ek tarah se khatre mein hai. क्या सोशल फैब्रिक देश की खतरे में 2015 में ही पड़ी? Why didn't you think of returning the award earlier? आज ही क्यों आपको सोच में आया, आपने सोचा कि अवार्ड वापस करना चाहिए?
देखिए, जो मैंने सोशल फैब्रिक की बात की है, एक बात मैं स्पष्ट कर दूं, वो मैंने साहित्य और कल्चर पे जो हो रहा है उस दृष्टि से की है. मैं उसमें ये जो रिलीज दंगे हैं, मुझे पता था कि इससे बहस डिरेल हो जाएगी, उसको उसमें नहीं लिया. ये आपका सवाल बिल्कुल ठीक है, और लोग भी पूछते हैं कि अब क्यों. उसका जवाब जो मैं समझता हूं वो ये है कि इससे पहले जो होता था, ये नहीं कि ये अभी शुरू हुआ है, साहित्यकारों को सभ्याचारक के जो वर्कर हैं सभ्याचार के उन पे अटैक होने अब शुरू हुए. हुसैन की मिसाल हमारे सामने है. लेकिन उस समय जो मौके की सरकार थी वो अपनी वोट बैंक राजनीति के कारण, चाहे जो क्रिमिनल हैं उनको पकड़ के दो दिन बाद छोड़ दिया खबर पढ़ने के, लेकिन कोलैबोरेट नहीं करती थी, पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करती थी.
लेकिन हुसैन साहब फिर भी इंडिया वापस नहीं आए. हुसैन डिड नॉट कम बैक टू इंडिया. व्हाई डिड राइटर्स नॉट से दैट वी आर गिविंग अप आवर साहित्य अकादमी अवार्ड स्टिल एमएफ हुसैन कम्स बैक टू इंडिया?
देखिए, एक अकमुलेशन होती है प्रोटेस्ट की. ये जरूरी नहीं कि इस स्टेज पे क्यों ना किया. अब जो कुछ हो रहा है, साहित्य को कल्चर को पोल्यूटेड कह के उनको निंदनीय चीजें बनाया जा रहा है, और साहित्यकारों से ऐसे बिहेव किया जा रहा है जैसे वो क्रिमिनल हो.
एंड इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद नरेंद्र मोदी गवर्नमेंट और मिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी हिमसेल्फ. ये प्रोटेस्ट जो आपका है, कुछ लोग कहते हैं राइटिस्ट के खिलाफ है, राइटिस्ट गवर्नमेंट है. देयर इज अ राइटिस्ट गवर्नमेंट इन दिल्ली. लेफ्टिस्ट राइटर्स आर प्रोटेस्टिंग अगेंस्ट द राइटिस्ट गवर्नमेंट.
देखिए, एक बात मैं स्पष्ट करूं, मैं पंजाबी के लेखकों की आपको लिस्ट दे देता हूं जिन्होंने ये इनाम वापस किया है. उसमें से मैं आपको एक लिस्ट दूंगा. मैं 1,00,000 रुपया एक राइटर का दूंगा अगर आप उनको लेफ्टिस्ट के कांग्रेस के साथ भी अलाइड शो.
सो इट हैज नो पॉलिटिक्स.
नो पॉलिटिक्स.
बट इज योर फियर, एंड दिस इज वेयर यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम, इज योर फियर दैट दिस विल बिकम पॉलिटिकल?
Yes.
Given the manner in which yes. also the political class of this country responds, they will see the likes of Mr. Bhullar not as writers, but in some way that they are aligned yes. with the opposition.
Absolutely.
Is that a fear that you have?
Absolutely. That's my fear. Because that's how this country works. Abhi, we were in another program mm-hmm. where they were just fighting among themselves, the three political politicians or
so you're folksmen. Worried that the writers will get caught in the crossfire
Absolutely.
Between politicians.
Absolutely.
But at the same time, ma'am, when M.M. Kalburgi is shot dead, the Sahitya Academy does not even have a condolence message for him.
That is
does not even put a condolence meeting for someone who's a Sahitya Academy Award winner. Naturally, question will be asked.
May I answer that?
Yes, please.
I believe there was a condolence meeting held in Bangalore with the vice president there. Kambar was there. Mm-hmm. And it was a very widely attended conference.
Not organized by the academy, I'm told. But you
Kambar was there, so it has to be by the academy. But I'm told by people who were present in the Shok Sabha, reputed writers like the Tamil writer Vasanthi, mm-hmm. that no comment was made about his murder. That there was no sense of shock or outrage, mm-hmm. and there was no condemnation of the murder. You know, a writer dying a natural death and a writer being killed are two different things. You have a condolence meeting for many writers, you know, who die, but a writer who is shot dead for his ideas, the Sahitya Academy should have condemned it.
But that is precisely it. Is there a sense from what Mr. Bhullar is saying that writers today? Mm. Who should enjoy the right to dissent, should have the right to express their views.
Yes.
Today find themselves possibly in an environment, and maybe over the last few years, not just today, it's been building up over a few years, where they are increasingly hostage to all kinds of outside pressure with no protection.
Yes.
And therefore they are entitled to have this protest.
With no protection.
That so is therefore true. They are protesting. So
yes,
therefore they are protesting.
Protesting. But what I am feeling, what I feel is that they are targeting the Sahitya Academy. The Sahitya Academy made a big mistake, a very, very big mistake by not condemning mm-hmm. Kalburgi's killing. But the unfortunate thing is, in all these 65 years, 60 mm-hmm. plus years, Sahitya Academy has never condemned any writer's killing.
So that reflects very poorly on the Sahitya
Absolutely.
Academy. But the question is, Bhullarji, 1984 anti-Sikh riots take place, 2002 Gujarat riot takes place, 92-93 Ayodhya riots take place, communal riots have taken place in this country over the years. Many believe that this is now being linked to the communalization. But communalization didn't take place in 2015, ये तो सालों से हो रहा है. दादरी जैसी जो incidents हुई हैं, इसी तरह के अन्य घटनाएं दूसरे राज्यों में भी हुई हैं. The question therefore is कि क्या ये कहीं ना कहीं आपने नरेंद्र मोदी से जोड़ा है? क्योंकि अगर नहीं जोड़ा है, तो why was this not done before? ये लोग पूछते हैं.
देखिए, एक तो मैं बात ये स्पष्ट कर दूं आपको कि मैंने जो रोष किया है वो सिर्फ साहित्य और सभ्याचार पे जो कुछ हो रहा है,
It's only on
उसमें किया है.
सिर्फ साहित्य पर.
सिर्फ मैंने साहित्यकार के नाते मुझे ये पुरस्कार मिला, साहित्य अकादमी ने दिया और मेरी साहित्यिक पुस्तक पे दिया.
So
तो जब मैंने एक
इसका कोई पॉलिटिक्स से लेना देना नहीं,
मेरा कोई पॉलिटिक्स का, मेरा जो स्टेटमेंट
तो दादरी में जो हुआ उसके बाद ये
इसमें नहीं लिया,
बिल्कुल नहीं,
नहीं इसमें नहीं लिया. मैंने अपने रोष में उसे शामिल नहीं किया. उसकी एक वजह है, ये नहीं कि उन बातों का मुझे दुख नहीं है, 84 तो मैंने खुद झेला है
जी,
लेकिन मुझे पता था कि जो अभी जैसे इन्होंने कहा हम एक प्रोग्राम देकर आए हैं तो उसमें पॉलिटिशियंस को डिरेल करने का मौका मिलता है, तब क्यों ना किया. दूसरी बात यह है कि अब जो है, जैसे मैंने पहले कहा कि स्टेट या तो चुप है या साथ कोलैबोरेट कर रही है अटैक करने वालों को. अब देखिए, आज हमारे कल्चर मिनिस्टर का आया है बयान कि अगर ये घुटन महसूस करते हैं ना लिखें.
You know, that is precisely it. You know, yes. if a culture minister of this country is going to say, agar writers ko ghutan mehsoos hoti hai, yes. they should not write.
Yes.
Is this the toxicity in the yes. air that has to be stopped?
Absolutely.
And therefore writers have to come together.
Absolutely.
Your only weapon is yes. in a sense your pen.
Rajiv ji, jo isme chinta ki baat hai, jo sabko chinta karni chahiye, wo ye hai ke sahit ko, sabhyachar ko, writers ko, इनको निंदनीय शब्द बनाया जा रहा है.
ये आपने बड़ी अच्छी बात की है. देयरफॉर आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू इन कंक्लूजन मृदुला जी, इफ यू हैड अ मैसेज फॉर द कल्चर मिनिस्टर ऑफ दिस कंट्री, व्हाट वुड इट बी?
रिजाइन.
रिजाइन
बिकॉज यू हैव नथिंग टू डू विद कल्चर. And if you know nothing about culture, please do not be a culture minister.
You are making a very strong point. Yes. You are saying Mahesh Sharma. So you are now saying, while you will retain your award because you believe the Sahitya Academy should retain its autonomy,
yes,
you are saying the culture minister should resign, yes, because he has no idea of culture.
I am also saying one thing more, that on 23rd October, yes, when they have their emergency board meeting, the Sahitya Academy, I hope they will pass a resolution condemning Kalburgi's killing. And if they have never done it before, that does not mean that they cannot start now.
Okay. Very strong words. I hope, Mahesh Sharma, you are listening. This is perhaps the reason why writers are angry. If you as culture minister, sir, are going to say that if writers are feeling suffocated, then they should stop writing. Well, then you shouldn't be the culture minister of the country, is the verdict of our writers. Mridula Garg, Gurbachan Bhullar, appreciate your joining us. Thank you very much.